since this final table began, Barg. It's been Donal Norton, the big mover. Lines of 25 and 50. And pins and needles on tap. Here's Dunwoody under the gun. And
player all in.
Quick call. Quick call from Donal Norton. He's going to have ace jack beat. I think Dunwoody knows it.
Not necessarily.
It's 300 odd thousand.
Probably be split half.
Okay, 1-0 to me, Jesse.
Ace.
I mean, I've loved the way Norton has played this tournament so far, but I don't like the call. Dunwoody has been sitting there like a sack of spuds so far today. He hasn't done anything. He hasn't really had a hand to do it, but when he's moved, you can take it. He can beat ace 10.
And the flop is Jack King.
Oh, ace 10 still drawing live. What a shot in the arm. This is going to beat a Dunwoody if the queen doesn't come. It's giving a couple more outs for Norton here. Two tens, four queens. But the jacks hold. And Parg, was that just a brain freeze or something?
Yeah, I think that was a mistake from Norton. Sometimes, if there's any beginners watching this, it's a very good idea if you just stop and think, even for 15, 20 seconds, the quick call there was probably something he wouldn't have done if he thought about it for 30 seconds. But you can't expect, like, this guy's, he's become a very good tournament player in a very short time.
And let's go down to Kieran O'Leary to hear what he thinks about this. Kieran, very quick call.
Unbelievable. I can't believe it. How does Donald, you've got to take a little bit of time, try and put your opponent on a hand. In my opinion, he's made a mistake. He might have felt that he's got momentum with him. As Parag said, you got Dunwoody, he's just been sitting there, he's just waiting for a premium hand. You had to figure that your ace 10 wasn't any good, Jesse.
All of a sudden, there's a lot of play in these stacks, aren't there?
Yeah, that was Dunwoody was on life support there, and now he's right back there with a comfortable stack. Dunwoody might actually think he's got way more chips than he needs.
I mean, Tim Blake with 600,000, it looked like at the start of this final table he could fold his way to at least third. All of a sudden, he's the short.
Neil on the button.
He still got 2.6 of the 2.7 he started with. Just a feeling that everybody's got their seatbelts on.
Channing's not alone playing for the money and the title. He's also playing for the title, maybe being the worst dressed winner at the Irish Open ever. And a couple of good markers have been put down for that one.
I've been watching him wear that shirt for near on a year and a half, and it never occurred to me until earlier in the week that he's actually not wearing an undershirt. This has something to do with Arsenal in the 70s. Get the whole.
Well, I think you want a better excuse than that, to be honest with you.
The whole thing together. He does look like a goon, though.
Suited.
You got to dress like that. I mean, if you're going to be dressing like that, it's got to be to win a bet, doesn't it?
Channing on the button, Paulson in the big blind. A similar hand he had last orbit and just called before the flop.
I think he'd be re-raising here.
You have to say what the suit is.
A lot of guys would call, but there's a lot of guys would throw it away. I think.
Oh, is it not?
And a lot of guys would re-raise with it.
What does that mean?
I think Paulson's from the re-raising school.
It's a total of 130, 50 plus 80. And what would be the deciding factor?
London, you can say what you like now. They don't care. You say you can name your two parts.
Well, I think you may make this like 450. I mean, with the implication that the rest is going in if Channing wants to make an issue of it.
Is there any kind of read from Channing? He's doing a lot of talking.
Well, he kind of talked himself into losing a customer last night at one stage. But, he's English. He likes doing a bit of talking.
He's taken off a flop here, and this could be dangerous because Channing has the kind of cards that can hit, and they have Parg. Straight draw versus top pair.
This whole tournament could change right here.
Nice check by Channing, 5 or 10. He's hit the Knox Park.
Oh, wow. This is big, big trouble for Paulson.
He could be out.
Interesting to see how Channing plays this. Paulson is probably about 200.
Park, is this the danger with taking off flops?
160,000.
I bet 160,000 in total.
This is decision time for Channing.
How much black do you have? was it? 15
Obviously, he's got the best hand you can possibly have. So even though Channing is English, he'll work out. He's got the nuts here. It's just a question of how he wants to play this hand to extract the most chips from Poulsen. You know, if he thinks that maybe Poulsen is just bluffing here, I mean, you can look a little bit sick and just call and hope to pick up a few chips from another bet on the river. Or if he thinks that Poulsen is strong, he can.
Which way is going to get the most
chips? Pair and a draw?
If he makes a big raise here, is Poulsen going to call?
Let's find out. 450.
Raised to 450,000. Raised
to 450,000.
That's a serious question to be asking. Poulsen will be aware at this stage, Parg, he's playing for his tournament, right?
Well, he should be. Well, it looks like Channing has decided that Poulsen's got something. He's certainly not going to let him, you know, draw the flush here cheaply. He's decided this is the way he wants to do it. Maybe get Poulsen to commit all his chips.
Seems like a very tough fold to make here for Poulsen, isn't it? I mean,
but it can be very hard to read Channing because, you know, the range of hands that Channing will raise with. I mean, obviously, 9-7 is one of them, but there's all sorts of things like 10-8, 8-6, King-10.
Nice pitch.
You know, Channing's one of these guys that because he raises so many hands and raises with so many different types of hands, you can't, it's very hard to put him into a category or, you know, come up with a range of hands that he may have. I mean, basically, Channing's range of hands, both to make the raise before the flop and to make this raise here in the turn is just about any two cards they give him. I mean, this is where the, you know, taking a chance with bad cards really pays off for a guy.
Poulsen's
taking a hell of a lot of confusion.
He's taking his time about it. That's a good trade.
This man is good.
But how can he fold it?
Norton can learn a little bit by looking at Poulsen here that he's taking his time. He's not doing anything in a hurry. If there is a flaw we've seen in Norton's game today, it's to act now and think later. You know, a lot of players in Channing's position would just keep their mouth shut and let the other guy try and talk himself into something, but Channing, you know, if you get involved in speech play in the middle of a hand, you better know what you're doing.
I think Neil just can't help himself sometimes.
There's another. It may not be a poker thing at all.
He's having too much fun.
He loves it, doesn't he?
And the longer this goes on, is it more of an indication that Paulson's going to move the money or the cards?
You know, generally speaking, you know, if there's any beginners and enthusiasts out there, it's normally a good idea to forget a lot of the stuff you see on the TV, you know, with all these guys talking in the middle of hands, because if you're not a very, very experienced player, the chances are that you're going to give away way more information than you're going to get. Yeah. You know, there's guys like...
He's gone all in, and Neil's got him! It's Paulson's drawing dead! He's out! It worked, Borg! He talked him into it!
Neil has the strength with a 7-9.
I'm not entirely sure he talked him into it. I think Paulson might have just thought his hands.
He is drawing dead.
That probably means he's not going to win the hand. And you can't really blame Poulsen for doing this because Channing has been making those kind of plays all week. In fact, Channing's been making those kind of plays all his life. You know, he could have made that pot with a big draw. He could have made it with a bad king.
And stuff. Parg, when you roll this hand back, I mean... this 7-9, a lot of guys wouldn't have raised with it. It's turned into probably the biggest pot of the final table so far for Neil Channing and for Kai Danilo Poulsen, the one that knocked him out.
Well, Poulsen may live to regret the fact that he didn't re-raise Channing before the flop with the King Jack just to find out what was going on. You know, it's easier to say it now, but at the time, it didn't look like a good move.
He's going to have a nice paycheck for fifth place, but for Poulsen now, this final table over. I mean, look at that hand again. Open-ended on the flop, Channing checked, and then the nuts on the turn.
I didn't hit it on a big hand as he did, or on a flush draw straight or with Queen Jack, so I was very close to fold, so but I had to make a stand. Either all in or fold, and the time ran out, and I decided to just go for it and just hope he had a big draw, but he didn't, and it happens. Yeah.